So to start with, let's have a look at the 10 frame. Again, we can use 10 frames, and again, we're having our students use their skills of subitization or recognizing what the number is without actually counting them. So here's our example where we have 8. We're going to say, what do you have if you take away 4? And of course, the answer is 4. Once again, the students will learn to recognize the patterns of the numbers. And I think by using two colors, it helps to inform them that 8, which they'll recognize, can be seen as 4 and 4 or double 4. And so if you take 4 away, you'll have 4 left. Now, it's fair to say that when you present a child with a question that could be done as a halving question, they may not recognize it as such. So if we think of a question like 12 take away 6, the only way you're really going to know that's a halving question is if you already know that double 6 is 12, and so in a sense you already know the answer without thinking about it. So it's not a straightforward matter of just saying, oh, just halve it with these questions. But what we do want our students to do is to recognize that they already know a number fact in the addition group that will help them answer this one. So if we say 8 take away 4 and they're stumped, we would then say to them, well, what do you have if you start with 4 and the answer's 8? Or alternatively, do you remember what double 4 is? So we're going to refer often back to the addition number facts, and so the children will make that connection. And that, of course, is a principle for doing subtraction facts generally, that if you know your addition facts first, the subtraction is the reverse of that. So you have to rearrange the numbers in your mind, but the idea is that won't be that difficult. It's worth pointing out, of course, it's pretty obvious that for this to work, your students must know their addition facts. So if they're shaky on their addition facts, I wouldn't even attempt this. I'd give them more practice with addition.